We off the grid. We off the grid.
I'm off the grid. Got tattoos on my ribs. Tattoos on my ribs. I just tatted my kids. I just threw 20 county. We was in honest. I just bought me some brand new clothes. Double Street Market. We just took a ride to Charlotte. I'm in a Rolls Royce. You don't watch it, Cali. I light a up blunt and let you try. Them off the grid, I'm on
a die. We off the grid. This for my kid. Everything we did for the crib did hit. Nice way with this trip. Born grid, sex with G-Sticks.
Yeah, look, when I was in jail, I was low-key. Shout out to supporters that wrote me. Eat food, work out, and then go sleep. You know I'm praying he carrying both feet. Yeah. Niggas know we got God with us. He look at me and see a God figure. And when I stop vibing, I know that he with me. And I'ma always catch a hard shiver. I know it's demons in that dark liquor. We buy a bottle and a squad switch up. Everybody turn into a harsh nigga. But my pocket's bigger and my heart richer. My mind smarter, my grind harder, and my car quicker. I'm at her in church, she pray for me. She my God sister. Yeah. I'm only trusting the people I keep close. Niggas selling they soul for a repost. Remember when I was broke wearing cheap coats? And I was diamonds and houses and C-notes. Nigga, I'm feeling marvelous. They let the monster loose. They call me a product of my environment. I tell them no, I'm a God producer. Defense good and them guards can shoot. I put them on you, it get hard to move. Tattoo on my face is the mark of truth. Gotta watch what you say when they market you. I already predicted this. Y'all only witnessed it. Look, got a couple old friends that I'm not really clicking with. I know they pray that we settle our differences. I pray that they lower all my niggas' sentences. I got some demons I'm not even dealing with. They ain't feelings I'm not really feeling in. I know some members that gave back their membership. Nigga, you switched up. Like, how you not feeling me? Look, I act like I care, but I don't really care. Now I live in a new building with amenities. I got a new ceiling with a chimney. I got a few niggas wanna finish me. I don't get too friendly with the enemy. You gotta move different when you in the industry. Ooh, yeah, you gotta move different when you in the industry. You gotta move different when you look. God bless me with amazing grace. She fell in love with my day to day. I just want my problems to fade away. Man, I'm tired of niggas, I need Gatorade. Boy, I got on my feet and I made a name. And I made it a necklace. When you from the bottom and you working hard just to get to the top, then they gotta respect it. If you got a voice, then you gotta project it. If you got a wrong, then you gotta correct it. If you got a name, you gotta protect it. If you get me shocked, then you gotta elect. Tryna live a new life, so I got a new plan and I gotta finesse with. Look, cause they want me to lose, they ain't part of the rules. I be trying so hard not to move reckless.
Yo, what's good, YouTube? Hope y'all doing great, man. I hope y'all blessed. Hope you on your purpose and hope you get into a bag. Hope y'all enjoyed the clips as well. That was just from a workout I had did a few days ago. I'm actually filming the second half of the video. My bad for the noise and the cicadas. But I'm actually filming the second half of the video right now. Instead of that day, I just ran out of time that day to get it done. But I'm supposed to be dropping a video today. So this is that video and we are getting it out. But as you can tell by the title, man, I just wanted to hop on here and just kind of go through my mental transformation I've had with bodybuilding. So for those of you that don't know, I started working out about 3 years ago. I would say 2018. That was my New Year's resolution, and that's kind of when I started, and I've pretty much been consistent ever since. Started with going like 4 days a week, then five gradually, then up to six. And I pretty much been going 6 days a week for consistently the last year and a half, pretty much. Over that time period, of course, I've had the physical transformation. So I've gained about maybe 30 pounds of muscle over the period. And, you know, I've really transformed physically. But also, and I think even more important, is the mental transformation I went through. So it's kind of what I wanted to touch on today. So we can just hop straight into it. I guess to start, just speaking on how it's impacted myself and my own personal relationship with myself is the discipline aspect. So when you're going to do something hard every day, or, you know, something that's going to leave you sore or it's hard to get through, such as working out, over time, I've talked about it before, but I feel like hard things are what lead to discipline. So it's just really conditioned that discipline muscle for me by going every day and putting in the work and, you know, doing something hard, because you never regret a workout after you did it. You know, you're only going to dread going, but once you get it done, it's you're almost always gonna feel good about it. So I say, just transforming discipline has been huge for me. That has led to me being more disciplined in other areas of my life and trying to cultivate other habits such as diet and you know, business and just staying focused on my goals and just, you know, trying to steadily make progress towards them. So that would be probably number one, is the discipline aspect. Number two, also on the vein of my personal relationship with myself, I would say, is actually just like the mental sharpness. So like, I feel like working out gives you a sense of mental clarity. It's almost like a form of meditation when you're in there. So you are able to, you know, really free your mind of the daily stresses and kind of take it out on the gym. So if you're putting, you know, as men, we need these physical outlets, I feel like. And even women too, I feel like, just as humans in general, we need to be able to let these physical outlets, so it doesn't come out in a toxic or a negative way. You know, if we don't let it out through the gym or through these constructive practices, we can let it out through our relationships and treat people with an attitude, or go out throughout the day with the attitude, but or just be anxious and all these different types of things, just be more in your head. So I've noticed that since I've started working out, I've just been much more zen-like, you feel me? It's just much more stoic, and I don't really let shit get to me as much, and I'm just able to, you know, be cool throughout life. A lot of people are just overwhelmed, ready to snap at any instant and just have all this energy that hasn't been released in ever, you know? So just going there and pushing really hard, I think, is, you know, gonna be the key to that, is just really pushing yourself and, you know, tapping into that mode of how you feel and just getting it all out in the gym and just taking it out on the weights for real. So that would be number two. And then the last one I want to touch on, I want to make this video too long, but the last one I want to touch on is as far as how it's impacted my relationships with other people. So it still has something to do with myself. So I feel like just the confidence aspect is a huge mental transformation. The confidence and self-esteem. And I'm not saying that, well, I am saying that, you know, once you get that better body, it's gonna make you feel better about yourself. You feel me? So it's not like, I'm not gonna sit here and say, oh, the confidence came from just the mental aspect. Like, no, once you look better, subconsciously, you're gonna feel better about yourself. And once you feel better about yourself, that's when you can be more confident in yourself and have that, you know, better self-esteem, which has impacted, you know, relationships. So whether that be with girls and just more confident to approach them, and they may have even still, that's one thing I'm noticing about confidence. Girls may fuck with you, may have fucked with you in the past, you just weren't confident enough. And that just goes for the future too. Like, girls, you might not be ugly, you might just not be confident. And confidence, I feel like, is so key in not only girl relationships, but also, you know, platonic or business relationships too. If you're confident when you're going into a meeting, or you're confident when you're meeting with somebody, or going to a photo shoot, or, you know, whatever it may be, that's just gonna read off of you, and people are gonna sense that and treat you accordingly. Because you know yourself, and that's just a sign of a strong character, I feel like, it's confidence. Insecurity means you have, you know, work that you haven't did, that you haven't figured out. And sometimes we act like we can, you know, mentally heal every aspect about ourselves, when specifically with health, you can't really just strictly mentally gain confidence. I feel like confidence does have to come through some sort of work or, you know, putting something forward. So in this case, I'm talking about the gym. So by putting in that work in the gym and making your body look better, you're becoming more attractive. You have put in work for something and then experience the result. So that does something to the brain as well, aside from the physical aspect. Just the sense of fulfillment, like you went after a goal and you started achieving it. Because it didn't take for me to get, you know, my ideal physique or like how I am now to experience that confidence. I experienced that confidence boost quickly, like, you know, couple months into it, like 1 or 2 months into it. And I think it was just because of the progress aspect of me getting better, realizing I'm getting better, who I know if I continue at this pace, who I'll become, who I'll look like. All that played a big role in just the mental and self-esteem and confidence and all these different types of things like that. So just to recap, how bodybuilding has impacted my mental is, one, giving me a sense of more discipline, so making me a more disciplined person. Two, is allow me to be more zen and like get out the stress and just clear my mental, have a lot more mental clarity and mental sharpness because of the clarity. And then three, more confident and self-esteem. So that's like three big things that's helped me, and it's definitely I've experienced the result in my life, and it has made my life better and going up. So hope y'all enjoyed the video. If you did, go ahead and push the like button for me. Go ahead and subscribe as well if you're new to the channel. I got videos on how to become your best version while I am documenting the process of me becoming my best version. Couple little updates. I have dropped a podcast. It's called the Prosper Performance Podcast. You can type it in on YouTube at Prosper Performance, the channel. You can go to my Instagram page and click the link in the bio and then be able to go to it. I'll drop a link in the bio down below. Also, if you need a workout or a diet plan, I also have those, and I'm also a personal training now, so don't hesitate to reach out on my website. Also in the link in the bio, there is all the plans, and you know, there's a 4-day plan, 5-day, 6-day plan for men and women, and they're $25 right now. So, you know, $25 if you need a workout plan. It's gonna guide you through for 3 months of full physical transformation, and obviously you can experience the mental transformation benefits as well. I'm rambling now. There's a diet guide in there also for $10 to help you figure out what to eat to sustain without giving rid of your cravings and, you know, not going full diet mode. I think that's all the housekeeping issues. Like I said before, I hope y'all are doing great. You're just moving forward, you know, consistency and just moving forward and just trying to give value to the world. So with that being said, I will catch all of y'all in the next video. Take care. Peace.